The Mr. Excel podcast is brought to you by Easy Excel.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Challen. Well, I've been writing about Excel 2010 a lot, and one of the cool new features in Excel 2010 are the Sparklines. Now, Professor Tufte invented Sparklines, wrote about them in his book called Beautiful Evidence, and Sparklines are very small word-sized charts. Click OK. All right, so we get some Sparklines there. Now, I found that you kind of really have to adjust Sparklines a little bit. The first thing I like to do is I like to make the Sparklines larger, so like a height of around 55 or so. And the other thing that we find is that Sparklines each have their own scale. So here I want to compare these four different manufacturing lines. I really need to make sure that they all have the same scale. So I go into Sparkline Tools Design and then Axis. And I could say same for all Sparklines for both minimum and maximum, but I'm a bit of a control freak, so I want to set a custom value for the minimum. I'm going to set that to be 90, and then go back and for the maximum custom value, and let's say 110. That way I have absolute control over the min and max, and I can also do this really cool labeling trick. 110, Alt+Enter, 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 90. All right, now here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to make that a little bit smaller so it fits. I'm going to right justify. And now I actually have a little label over there that shows me the scale from 90 to 110. The other thing I'd like to do, you know what, let's change these to Spark columns. So I'll come here and say that we'll make it a column. I would actually like to put a label along the horizontal axis. Now, check this out. This is pretty cool. I'm going to do 7, Alt+Enter, 7 o'clock, 8, Alt+Enter, 9, Alt+Enter, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, so there's our times. All right, and we'll choose that. Now I'm going to go in to format cells, format cells, alignment. We're going to change that to be sideways text, and then horizontal we're going to say center, and vertical we're going to say top. All right, now see, it's way too big, so I'm going to go a lot smaller, and then I'm going to make the columns wider so that way things pretty much just about line up. Takes a little bit of tweaking here to get this to work. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2. Each column now has a number directly underneath it. Isn't that cool? Okay, so we now have that data. I need to see what the column width is. 16.71. We'll repeat that for the other columns. And then I can copy those labels across, and we now effectively have labels for each individual thing. Also, if there's room, you can actually get rid of these titles up here and move them right into the box. So line one, we can say, hey, we want that top aligned and center aligned, maybe a little bit smaller, and it'll work. So you're actually adding labels right to the individual Sparklines. I think it makes it much better to have some labels there above and below. Now Microsoft doesn't do that, but you know, easy enough in just a little bit of time there to go through and show that. So, some cool Sparkline tricks. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.